clock is right twice a day.
You said it, Bobby June. We're turning the clock. Under me, I'm about jobs and I'm about families. I've had 3 families and I've learned from my mistakes. I think people know that about me. I've made some bad decisions. Now, I'm ready to do good.
That's just so powerful. One of the things about me is I'm not a judgmental person. I don't judge people. Well, not white people. But you've got to learn from your mistakes.
Look, nobody's made more mistakes than me, Bobby, which is why I'm uniquely qualified to run the world's 6th largest economy. Hey, I know how to jump out of a burning building, and I give back to the community. As soon as I heard about so many people losing their homes in that storm in Liberty City, I flew out there for a special screening of my latest movie. It was to bring smiles and hope during the bleakest of times. Thanks to all that showed up, by the way. And with our cut of food and beverage concessions, it was a great positive event.
Bless your heart. So are you gonna help me cook this here supper or what, Jock?
It would be my pleasure.
So let's get in here. Let me grab some pots and pans and the fats and the salt and some butter. We're gonna need a little brown sugar, some margarine, baked beans, pork rinds, marshmallows, barbecue sauce, of course. Oh, white sugar, white lightning, and the bacon. Hey, bacon's God's way of saying he loves us. Ain't that right? Listen, Jock, before we get started, now you mentioned it earlier, I'm really fired up about vaccines and immunization in this country. And I mean, these shots will give you a disease and wait for your body to just fight it out. It's horrible. Listen, we never got my stepson Randy shots, and he was just happy as a peach, living his life to the fullest right up to the end when he died naturally of polio at the age of 7. I swear he didn't regret it for a minute. He told me so on his deathbed. Mama, name a casserole after me. And I said, why, hell, of course, Randy, you sweet little angel. Bless your heart. And I did. I called it Cripple's Crockpot.
Available in the frozen food section of your local supermarket while supplies last.
That sounds delicious.
Oh, honey, it is. It's one of my favorite recipes. Now, then we took little Randy's body outside and, you know, all his little stuffed animals and everything that was about him and made a bonfire and roasted a pig and had a potluck supper with all our neighbors. Now, that's how you work through grief. By surrounding yourself with friends and family and plowing through it with peach schnapps and cocktail wieners, tater tot pie and soda pudding. Comfort foods are for when you need comforting. That's why they call them comfort foods. If I'm mourning a polio-ridden stepchild, I ain't gonna cry into a salad, am I? No, I'm gonna rejoice the early passing of my dearest by making a big old batch of beef enchiladas that will shut down the blood to your brain and let you live in the moment like you just had a stroke.
You are so right, Bobby. And I have to say, these here hors d'oeuvres or Uber's d'oeuvres or appetizers are delightful.
Thank you, honey. I like to call them hors ovaries. Tastes great at first, but then you realize everyone else has stuck their fingers in the pudding. Also, I can't say anything in French. The only good thing that ever came out of France was the pizza.
Ain't that the truth? Take back the Statue of Happiness. It's ugly. Got a face like a sour fish.
She's just in a bad mood, isn't she? Speaking of French people, Jock, I want to talk to you about what you will do about promiscuity in this country. You know, on this show, we preach abstinence. If you don't want a bun in the oven, honey, stick it in the smoker.
I'm a big fan of sticking it in the smoker. Barbecue, tailgate parties, hell, I'd smoke anything. I teach my kids abstinence as well. My 16-year-old daughter will have her friends over to the pool, and I'll swim with them and play keep away, splashing around, you know, having fun, and I use that time to witness to them. I say, girls, this is a fantastic time in your life. You know, you're all so beautiful and burgeoning into womanhood, and a couple of you have developed fine breasts, as I see, and several about to fall out of your swimming costume. But don't do anything stupid that could ruin your life. Boys, they are trouble. Save yourself for your husband. You know, Bobby June, the important thing is that people learn about the decisions they are making in their own lives. And one decision we all gotta make is to stop letting immigrants ruin our economy. I mean, it just ain't right. You cannot get a job right now because foreigners have them. Well, America did not become the greatest country ever by letting foreigners in, and that's a fact. Listen, Bobby June. Listen, all of you. I am not a racist. I said some things, yeah, I did. That was a very long time ago. But there is a difference. If we want this country to be great again, we've got to start fighting wars we can win and stop fighting against crazy folk who ain't gonna give up, which is why I want us to think about invading Europe again. Seriously.
How do you mean?
Now, I ain't never been one for book learning, but I'm a big fan of history documentaries, and historical television shows us that America is at its finest when we invade Europe.
You know something? You're right!
Exactly. I mean, we've spent 50 years invading Asia and the Middle East, and it ain't right. Them folks don't want us to...
The music of Candido and Donald Byrd on the way, but right now, this is Tom Brown.
how you drive, right?
It was Donald Byrd, you in music, Tom Brown, Throwdown, original breaks for your beats, Peterson, Candido, and the Thousand Finger Man.
Look out, dog. We'll be right back.
is Chaz from Touring Mar, you're listening to Giles Peterson Worldwide.
Hey man, we're gonna need some body work done.
it from Spain? Who's it from? Kyo Dai. Out to everyone chilling right now in Galileo Park. Music from Toro y Moi. We're keeping it going. We're keeping it rolling. GP, it's Worldwide FM.